All right, here we go. This will be a brief walkthrough how to use the Celtix desktop and the new Celtix Shots app for the iPad. So what I've done here is I've taken extracted a part of a script I've written previously in Celtix to use as an example. So yeah, let's just export this script to the iPad. And I did add an extra scene that's not really there, but just it's just for demonstration purposes, so you can see how it works with multiple scenes in the script when you come into the storyboarding app on the iPad. So yeah, script exported. So let's move over to the iPad and see what we can do with it. I'm sorry about the recording quality, but yeah, it's not the most easiest thing in the world to record an iPad screen. But yeah, here we go. Okay. This is just some demonstration storyboard that were included with the app and me playing around. So let's import the script from Celtix Sync. So this is a script we just exported from the desktop. So I will open it now in the app. And immediately we get a storyboard set up with the correct name. And we have the two scenes. Divided here or split up as two sequences, and there's a bug here apparently. Oh, first of all, you can click on the small icon here on each sequence and see where in the script that sequence are referring to. So you can, while laying out the storyboard, you can always check the script and see what you're doing. And as you can see here, one part of my name disappeared when exporting it. I don't know if it's this particular case or if it's a bug all the way. I haven't had the time to check more into this, so I'm just writing back the location here for this scene heading. And just like in the desktop application, if you use the storyboarding part in Celtix desktop, you will feel pretty comfortable here because it works pretty much the same. So I have a storyboard here I've previously drawn that I imported into my iPad image library. So I can just select images from this storyboard and add to this sequence. And if you have, I have an iPad 1. If you have an iPad 2, you can of course use the built-in camera to capture photos right away into your storyboard, which I believe is very, very handy if you work on a location with live footage. I work animation, so for me it's not the camera is not that important to me, but for a live movie I can really see where that could be useful. But I draw my storyboards by hand, and I often draw the storyboards on the iPad in an application called Procreate, which is very nice to draw in. So this will be very handy to combine those two. Anyway, and for each storyboard frame, you can make a sketch to block out how you're going to make the shot. So I went into the sketch mode here for the first frame, and you have a library of clip art for useful symbols when you sketch out. So here you have a bunch of different camera symbols you can work with. And I drew out the rectangle here because this scene is taking place on a roof. So that rectangle will symbolize the roof for me. And of course, you can also probably get the roof clip art, but I only have the basic clip art set up. There is a bunch of other, I will show that later, but a bunch of other packages of clip art you can download. Let's just take an arrow to show how I'm going to move the camera in this shot, because I'm going to let it fly by the roof. So yeah, very simple sketch, but it will tell me how I want to make the shot. And then I can continue make a sketch for each and every frame with using the built-in clip arts and things like that, and keep working on designing. And for each, just like in the desktop application, for each frame here, you can select the shot type, if it's a wide shot, a point of view, a panning shot, and you can write a short description. And this will also show up when you play the storyboard later on. So pretty handy. And especially the shot type is something I find useful to note on each storyboard frame. And if you have a large storyboard, you can navigate with the scene headings in that menu, and you can switch between only seeing the sketches, only seeing the storyboard images, or seeing both of them at the same time, so you can filter it down a bit. And just like in the desktop app as well, you have a player for the storyboard, so you can play it up, and you can set the timing or the speed. I don't think you can set the per frame, unfortunately, so you can only set the timing for the entire entire shot or the entire storyboard. It would be pretty handy to set per frame. And also you can choose not to display the sketches here, but only the storyboard images and so on, so you can tweak it a little bit in a way. And well, I guess that's pretty much it. You can add new sequence, of course, that weren't in the script originally, because perhaps you had part of a script and then you keep working, so you can just add new sequence. Or if you start working on a storyboard from scratch as well, it's not always that you have a script to work on that you can import. So yeah, so you can add how many new sequences you want, and keep making sketches, keep adding drawings, keep adding photos, and all these clip arts that are that you can import, you can control, you can tweak, you can resize them, you can rotate them. And yeah, here's a bunch of people, and you have to excuse my touchability right now, because I made quite I have a camera in front of my face that makes this a little bit hard for me. I'm not used to recording the iPad screen. I will have to improve my iPad recording ability, I guess, if I'm going to make any more iPad videos. Anyway, and you can add new clip art, you can draw lines, you can draw arrows and stuff like that. And I briefly went over the library of additional clip art you can download for a fee, of course. But I would really like to be able to add my own clip art. And then unfortunately I can't sync it back, so you have to export it to iTunes, as I did there, to get it back into the desktop. Anyway, that's it. I hope you enjoyed it, and check it out if you find it interesting. Cheers!